The Champions Cup. Try to read along and practice. Let's get started. In this story, you'll see Ivan flex. Ivan is super stretchy. He can stretch his body in any direction. He once stretched his arms all the way around Hero Academy. Cam or switch. Cam has the power to turn into different animals. She once stopped some baddies from robbing a bank by turning into a giraffe. Chapter 1. The Test. As Ivan stepped off the bus, he heard the shrieks of monkeys and the squawks of exotic birds. Over the fence, he saw a giraffe stripping the leaves off a branch with its long tongue. The rest of the class jumped off the bus too, chattering excitedly. "Quieten down or this trip is over," warned Mr. Trainer. The class fell silent. This was no ordinary trip, and no one wanted to go home early. "Today, you will be competing to win the Champions Cup," Mr. Trainer said grandly. "Winning the cup is a great achievement. It's not easy. Over the years, many of our best pupils have tried and failed." "My mom won it when she was a pupil," exclaimed Cam. "The names of the previous winners are engraved on the cup," Mr. Trainer said. He looked around at each of the children. "If you complete the challenge and find the cup, your name will take pride of place next to theirs." "I'm definitely going to win the Champions Cup," Cam said excitedly. "I want to see my name next to my mom's." "Not if I get there first," Ivan said. "May the best hero win," Cam replied with a grin. "Class, you have 1 hour to find the cup and bring it to me." Mr. Trainer held up his stopwatch. "On your marks, get set, be super." Chapter 2. Pride of Place. Ivan sprinted up to the ring-tailed lemurs. He looked in their enclosure for the Champions Cup, but all he could see were the lemurs' big round eyes staring back at him. "No sign of the cup or Cam," he thought, checking behind him. Ivan ran on. Next, Ivan reached the penguin enclosure. He pressed his face against the glass and peered in. A penguin shot through the water, chasing a fish that the keeper had just thrown in. But there was no sign of the cup. "I hope Cam hasn't found it yet," thought Ivan, racing away. Ivan ran to the lion enclosure. One of the lions yawned, revealing its long, sharp teeth. Suddenly, Ivan remembered Mr. Trainer's words. "Your name will take pride of place." "Pride, that's it," Ivan said with a gasp. "A pride is another name for a family of lions. Who better to guard the cup than lions?" Ivan noticed Cam in the distance. "I'd better find that cup fast," he muttered. Chapter 3. Renter's Plan. Meanwhile, in another part of Lexis City, on the top floor of Renter Tower, Ray Renter switched on his massive wall of televisions. "Bunny One is report in," he ordered. "Any sign of the Champions Cup? I must have it. Why should only heroes get to win the cup?" "Ray Renter. Catchphrase: heroes are zeros. Hobbies: stamp collecting." He would love nothing more than to have a set of Renter stamps. Likes: white rooms, white suits, turnips because they're white. Dislikes: all colors and raspberries because their hairy and raspberry stains are impossible to remove from white suits. Beware. He created robotic rabbits, bunny wannies, to help him carry out his dastardly plans. A bunny wannie appeared on the screen. It's enough. You found the champion's cup in the lion enclosure, replied Runtor in surprise. Good work, my one-eyed friend. Added the bunny wannie. Yes, bring it to me as quickly as possible, ordered Runtor. Try not to run into any of those pesky heroes. Ray Runtor watched as the bunny wannie dragged the champion's cup past the lions and towards the glass wall of the enclosure. Tin-nin-nin, snuffed the bunny wannie. Ha! Said Riot Runtor. Good plan. If the lions escape, those tiresome heroes will be too distracted to stop us from stealing the cup. The bunny wannie hopped closer to the glass wall. It concentrated hard. Suddenly, a laser beam burst from its eye and struck the glass. The glass melted away like ice in the sun. The bunny wannie bounced out. Then, with a graceful leap, one of the lions sprang after it towards the hole in the glass. Chapter 4. Evans gasped as he saw the bunny wannie hop out of the enclosure, clutching the champion's cup. He was about to give chase when a massive lion leaped out in front of him. It let out a bone-chilling roar. Evans could smell the stink of its hot, meaty breath. Nice, nickety, Evans stuttered. He tried to back away, but his legs were trembling too much. The lion licked its dagger-like teeth and padded closer. Even glanced left and right. There was no one around to help him. He knew he couldn't outrun a lion. Even tried to summon his powers, but nothing happened. He was rigid with fear. Unable to stretch, come on, he shouted at himself, come on. Even tensed his whole body, concentrating on his power, but it was no good. Help, he yelled. Just then, Even heard a sound. Someone is coming. Help is on the way, he thought. However, when he looked over his shoulder, he saw to his horror that a second lion was heading straight towards him. Even watched, astonished, as the second lion hurtled past him. It bounded straight towards the first lion and forced it back into the enclosure. Then the second lion turned and stared at Even. He shut his eyes tightly as he waited for it to attack. When nothing happened, Even carefully opened one eye at a time. The lion stared back at him with huge emerald green eyes, and then it winked. Chapter 5. The Final Chance. Come, thank you. You saved my life, Even said. In a flash, Cam returned to normal. Don't mention it, she said. Now, if I'm not mistaken, that's the champion's cup. Even spun around and saw a bunny wannie running along a fence. It was clutching the cup. I've got this, said Even. His body tingled as he stretched. Even's arms grew longer and longer, until he was able to grab the champion's cup out of the bunny's paws. For a moment, the bunny wobbled on top of the fence. Then it lost its balance and toppled backwards, disappearing out of sight. Back in Runtor Tower, Ray Runtor snapped his remote control in half. No! Runtor cried. Those troublesome heroes are always wrecking my plans. Snapped the bunny wunny. I don't want to hear it, snarled Runter. Next time I'll do it myself and I won't fail. Meanwhile, on the Hero Academy bus, Mr. Trainer was making a speech. We have a Champions Cup winner. Ivan, I am delighted to... Wait, Ivan interrupted. It shouldn't be me. Cam deserves to win. She saved me from the lion. Mr. Trainer listened as Ivan told him what happened. Cam showed true bravery in the face of danger. Mr. Trainer declared, "Congratulations, Cam. You are the winner." As Cam stood up to receive the cup, Ivan grinned. "Your mom will be proud," he said. Everyone cheered for Cam. Once the cheering had died down, Cam looked at Mr. Trainer. "I'd like Ivan's name to be on the cup too. If it wasn't for him, that bunny Wani would have stolen it. Ivan deserves to win the cup as much as I do. Ivan deserves to win the cup as much as I do. That sounds fair to me," Mr. Trainer replied. Cam and Ivan smiled at each other as the bus pulled away, heading back to the academy. "Just as long as my name appears first," Cam added with a wink. That's the end of the story. Thank you for watching.